Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Are you tired of performing repetitive tasks on Moodle? Like moving, hiding, or deleting multiple resources or activities? Well, you're in luck. The Mass Actions block is here to save you time and effort. In this video, we'll explore how this powerful tool can streamline your workflow by allowing you to perform actions on multiple items at once. Let's dive in. First, I'll show you the bulk actions block within Moodle, and then I'll show you what the Moodle mass actions block is capable of. Before Moodle 4.2, you had to turn editing on, and then if you want to move things around, you have to click, drag it to the position where you want to add it and release your mouse, or you need to click on the three ellipses and then click on move. And then this menu appears or this window appears, and then you need to select the activity to where you want to move it after or before. And that was quite a tedious task, especially when you need to move or hide or delete multiple activities within your course. So if I want to delete this, I need to click on the ellipses and then click on delete, and it will delete accordingly. And then if I want to delete something else, I need to go to the ellipses again, click on it, and then delete. Or if I want to hide it, I need to hide it separately. Okay? But with the bulk action menu or the bulk action button here, you can do bulk actions on multiple activities within your course. Let me show you how this is done. Okay? First, you need to make sure that editing is turned on. As soon as you turn on editing, this button or menu item will appear. You can click on it once. So hover your mouse over it, click on it once, and now at the bottom here, this bar will appear. The first one is select all, and here you can select all the activities. The second one is availability. Here you can hide or unhide certain elements within your course. The third one is duplicate. And here you can make copies of certain activities. Then you can move things around, and then you can delete things. Okay, so what makes this different? So here you'll see, once I've clicked on that bulk action, you'll see that these squares appear next to the activities. So now I can select the squares that I want to delete. So let's say I want to delete those two, and then this one as well. Let's just check here. Okay, I want to delete this one as well. And let's select another one. I want to delete this one as well. Okay, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4 activities that I've selected. Now I want to delete them. So I just click on delete. This pop-up will appear. It will tell me this will delete 4 activities and any user data they contain. So if I accept it, I can click on delete, and those activities will be removed from the course. If I want to move things around, so let's say I want to move this or the whole topic. If I want to move the whole section here, I select the section and this will automatically be selected. So I'll choose this section as well, and this one, and this one. So I want to move this to the bottom. Okay, or let's move it to the top. So I'll click on move. And now I need to select to where I want to move it to. Okay, so I'll move it here just underneath teaching with Moodle. So I'll click on that and it will move it to under teaching with Moodle. So there it's moved. So there teaching with Moodle, and I've moved these 4 sections. If I want to duplicate activities, I can't select this section. Okay, so I need to select individual activities that I want to duplicate. So you see, I've selected this activity, this one here, this one, this one, this one, and this one. I want to duplicate that, so I'll just click on duplicate, and there you'll see that it made a duplicate of all those activities. as well as the heading, the module overview here. So we have two module overviews. If I want to delete it, I'll just select it again. There you go, and then just delete it, and then delete. Okay, and this makes it so much easier to move things around or copy things or delete things or even hide things. So if I want to hide certain elements within my course, previously I had to select one and hide it, then select another one and hide it. But here I can select multiple activities within my course and then select availability. So here the pop-up appears. What do I want to do? Show on course page or hide on course page? I can then select hide on course page and then apply. So it won't be available to the students. So now immediately you'll see hidden from students, hidden from students, hidden from students. If I want to remove this completely, this bar here, I'll just click on the X here and it will be available at the top here. As easy as that. Now, moving things around, deleting things, or copying activities within your course becomes so much easier to do with this bulk action button. You just click on it and then you use the menu items that you need, okay, to move things, to delete things, to duplicate things, or to hide things from your students. Remember, this is only available from Moodle 4.2 onwards. Okay, so the bulk action menu item is only available from Moodle 4.2 onwards. Now let's go a step further. Let's go to our Moodle's plugin directory. So type in moodle.org, go to moodle.org, and then go to your plugins. And then in your search box, type in mass actions. Click on search. And then the first one here, let's download this. Remember, I'm on Moodle 4.4. You may be on a different version, so download the correct version. So if this doesn't appear for you, or if this isn't really for you, let me show you how to use this mass action block. Okay, so I'll download mine 4.4 version. I'll then go to my site, go to site administration, and then go to plugins and then install plugins. And then I will select the plugin that I've uploaded and then I'll install it. Continue through the installation process and then I'll continue here. And then I'll upgrade my Moodle database now. So there's successfully installed. I'll leave it on its default. Here it says applicable course format. So here you can choose. I usually select all, so it will be applicable to all course formats. Okay, so now let's go to our course. I'll go to my Moodle 4.0 course again. Okay, so now you need to activate the block. Okay, I'll click on add a block and then I'll select the mass action block. This will immediately add the block at the bottom here. If you want to use the block, okay, you need to click on enable bulk editing. I'll click on that and now immediately this bar appears, but also this block menu items. Okay, here we can select all. Within the drop down list, we can select a section. So if I select teaching with Moodle, you'll see it becomes selected here. If I want to deselect all, it will deselect, or I can select all and it will select all my activities within my course. Now I can perform these actions with the selected items. Okay, I can show, I can hide. If I click on hide, it will hide all the selected activities within my course. Okay, I can scroll down again now enable edit, enable bulk editing, and then just select all again and show all. Okay, and then it will show all my activities. Then again, so if you want to use the block, you need to enable bulk editing. Okay. Now, what differs from this block here and the block here below? This one here, you can move certain elements around as well. So here you'll see that you can show it, hide it, duplicate it, but you can duplicate to another course. So if I want to move any items here or activities here to a different course, I can do this with this plugin, okay, which makes it quite nice to use. Okay, so let's go through the list. I can delete items, I can show description, I can hide the description. I can also, if I added new or updated the content, I can send a notification to my students within my course that the activities were updated. Okay, so which is very nice with, and it differs from this plugin here, the core plugin of Moodle. Okay, so let's move a section. So I'll choose here section to move. So I'll move teaching with Moodle. So it selects this section here. Then I want to move it to customize learning example section one. I want to move it to that spot there. Okay, so I'll click on move. It will then take that activity and move it down to where I've indicated it to move it to. Okay, so it moved it down to the section. Just check here. There we go. So it moved it down to this area here. Okay, so as simple as that. So you enable, then you select an activity that you want to move or delete or copy. So I'll click on start here. I want to duplicate that. So there we go. The action was executed. It was copied. And now I need to go find it. And now I can tell the block again that it should now perform another action. Okay. So start here. I want to duplicate to this one here. So this is for duplicate. This is for move. So I'll click on that. And now the action has been executed and it will duplicate it to the particular section. Really nice block to use and to have within your courses, since it makes moving, copying, deleting activities so much easier. And especially this function here, duplicate to another course. Okay, let's use this function. So I'll select the interactive course roadmap. And then I'll duplicate it to another course. Now it will ask me to which course I want to duplicate it to. So I want to duplicate it to the ICT skills. I'll then choose the course. It will ask me choose the section you want the selected course modules to be duplicated to. So I want to duplicate it to topic one and I'll choose that. Okay, so that's gone. So I made a copy of that. So let's go check on our ICT course. Okay, I'll check on my ICT course. So there's my course and there's my section that I've moved from my one course on Moodle to my ICT course. And this is the powerful feature of that particular plugin. Okay, so if I want to add the plugin here, let's do the mass action again. Okay, I'll enable it. Again, I can choose here. So you'll immediately see it identifies the different sections within my course. I want to move topic one. I want to duplicate it to another course. And it will ask me again to which course. I will move it to Moodle 4.0 or Moodle Activity Examples. I want to choose the course. And now it asks me to which section here. I'll click on a new section and I'll choose section. So there we go. So let's check. I'll go to my course, Moodle Activities, and there's our think we've copied it to the last section here in our course. Okay, so there we go. So there's our activity that we've copied from the one course to the next course. So if you have various courses but you want to use the same activity for different courses, you can copy it. Before this plugin, you had to backup and restore activities back in another course, but now you can copy across different courses on your Moodle platform, which makes it so much better than the Moodle's bulk action. Okay, I really hope this video was helpful. Please like and subscribe and hit the bell icon for further videos on my channel.